Can you hear me? I don't know if I like this one. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the first annual Art and Art of Sustainability Symposium. My name is Ryan Diebold, and I'm the Associate Director for the Lindy Institute for Urban Innovation here at Drexel. On behalf of the Mural Arts Institute and the Lindy Institute, I thank you all for joining us in the Saturday morning for what is sure to be a full day of engaging discourse on the intersection of art and the environment. The underlying intellectual aim of this symposium is to elucidate how organizations can use public art as a catalyst for community engagement, leadership, and stewardship in advancing sustainable solutions to a range of environmental challenges and opportunities. Our program today includes a great lineup of artists, scholars, and practitioners, and we hope that everyone in the audience will also have a chance to participate through the discussion and the interactive sessions that we have planned for today. For those of you who might not be familiar with the Mural Arts Institute, allow me to provide some background for you all. Founded in 2017, the Mural Arts Institute is dedicated to knowledge sharing, field building, and expanding innovation within the field of socially engaged art to those who see potential for this practice in their cities. For Mural Arts Philadelphia, the Institute is both an opportunity to share and an opportunity to learn. With this new program, Mural Arts will serve as a connector and convener through multi-city initiatives and symposia, such as this one, help design visionary art-based approaches to cities' most urgent challenges and opportunities, offer technical assistance that saves time and resources for those just starting out, host individuals and groups for deep, customized learning experiences in Philadelphia, and bring new ideas and practices to Philadelphia through visits from outside experts. As for the Lindy Institute for Urban Innovation, we are an applied research and think tank that operates in the interdisciplinary urban planning, design, and policy spheres here at Drexel. Our mission is to forge innovative strategies to equitably advance cities by drawing inspiration from Drexel's commitment to civic engagement and experiential education. Our vision aims to advance urban innovation through civic engagement at the service of society's greatest challenges, to train the next generation of engaged urban strategists to solve complex and dynamic cross-disciplinary urban challenges, and to create new knowledge and practices to enable our cities to function, prosper, and thrive in a complex and dynamic global society. You know, just the easiest of describes. Our work spans the fields of urban finance, econometric analyses, and policy solutions to civic visioning, creative placemaking, and public space performance research. The first annual symposia is offered as a part of the Mural Arts Institute's broader art and environment capacity building initiative, which is generously supported by the JPB Foundation and the Knight Foundation. The Art and Environment Capacity Building Initiative, which is a mouthful, is intended to help build the capacity of organizations nationally to, in what will be a recurring theme for today, use public art as a catalyst for community engagement, leadership, and stewardship in advancing sustainable solutions to a range of environmental challenges and opportunities. Philadelphia, as a typical post-industrial city, has a plethora of environmental issues, including emissions and air quality concerns, energy waste, stormwater management issues, land remediation issues, access to healthy foods, and waste management. And the city is not alone in facing these challenges. Many cities across the United States share similar histories and landscapes. Over the last decade, Philadelphia has established itself as a leader in green planning, applied scholarship and practice, with numerous organizations like the Philadelphia Water Department, the Mayor's Office of Sustainability under the previous Nutter administration, the Pennsylvania Horticultural Society, the Fairmount Park Conservancy, the Academy of Natural Sciences, the William Penn Foundation, the Knight Foundation, and numerous other organizations and individuals leading the charge. Mural Arts in particular has partnered with many of these organizations and others to build strong alliances, to add value to capital improvements, and to engage people in learning about and stewarding challenges. As part of the Art and Environment Capacity Building Initiative, they are excited to open a dialogue with other cities that are tackling these challenges. Their approach to this initiative will be collaborative, seeking to share knowledge, experiences, and resources while also facilitating learning among stakeholders selected to participate. In that regard, we are joined today by delegations from the initial three cities participating in the capacity building initiative. And I'd like to ask that these representatives raise their hands to identify themselves as I introduce everyone. From Akron, we have Arts Now and their partnering project Artists. as well as their environmental partner, the Ohio and Erie Canalway Coalition. Please raise your hand. Thank you, Akron. The Akron delegation hopes to leverage the arts to awaken a sense of community possibilities in Park East, a neighborhood in Akron adjacent to Summit Lake Park, in order to energize neighbors towards creating resolutions for common problems, either as individuals or as a collective. From Detroit, we have Live Six Alliance and Culture Source. Would you please identify yourselves? Thank you. The Detroit delegation is focusing on their focusing their efforts on the Fitzgerald neighborhood in Detroit, a location experiencing massive revitalization through extensive home rehabilitation and vacant lot transformation. The Live Six Alliance and Culture Source hope to use the arts to help ensure inclusive development processes and maintain and elevate the cultural heritage and history of the neighborhood. And from Memphis, we have the Urban Art Commission, Fraser CDC, Uptown Partnership, and they are also partnering with Clean Memphis and the Memphis Medical District Collaborative. Would you please identify yourself? All right, thank you. The Memphis delegation plans to work with individuals in the Fraser and Uptown neighborhoods in Memphis to create a public art project that increases neighborhood capacity to talk about and uplift neighborhood health, with the focus on crafting this process to be truly community-led with robust involvement from those constituents. And of course, I'm not sure if we have our representatives from our sponsors, but again, those are the JPB Foundation and the Knight Foundation. Are they here today? I think they might have, they were here yesterday, and I think they might have had to go back to their homes today. So thank you all for traveling all this way. We appreciate it. And once again, we welcome you to Philly and hope you have enjoyed your stay thus far. So I'm sure at this point you're getting sick of hearing me talk, so please bear with me for a moment while I introduce the first guest, Stacy Levy and Patti Phillips. So Stacy is a sculptor whose work links the worlds of art and science. She uses the language of landscape and art to tell the ecological story of site. From rivers to runoff, Stacy has explored the many facets of water: urban watersheds, tidal rivers, stormwater, water microorganisms, hydrologic patterns, and water treatment. Her projects reveal the sometimes hidden natural world in the urban environment. Stacy works closely with the landscape architects, engineers, horticulturalists, and hydrologists to create artworks that allow natural systems like the infiltration of rainwater to function and thrive and be celebrated. Stacy graduated from Yale University in 1984 with a BA in Sculpture and Forestry, and she received her MFA in 1991 from the Tyler School of Art. Her works have been commissioned throughout the United States, and she has created temporary works in Scotland, Japan, and Russia. Stacy lives on a farm in the Ridge and Valley province in central Pennsylvania with her husband, while her two children have both returned to Philadelphia. Patti is the chief academic officer at Moore College of Art and Design. Her breadth of experience includes her past roles as editor-in-chief of Art Journal, dean of graduate studies at the Rhode Island School of Design, dean of the School of Fine and Performing Arts at SUNY, chair of the Department of Art at the State University of New York, New Paltz, and program coordinator of the master's program in architecture and design criticism at the New School for Social Research at Parsons. In addition to her experience in academia, Phillips is a well-regarded writer, having published articles, essays, and reviews about contemporary art, design, and architecture in Art Forum, Art in America, Art Journal, Metropolis, and Public Art Review, among others. She authored the books City Speculations, It Is Difficult, you might have to help me with this one. It Is Difficult, Alfredo Yar and Ursula von Reidingsvarg. Is that right? Sweet. So Phillips' curatorial projects include a one-person exhibition on the artist Mural Lederman. Euclides? Okay. Yeah, a lot of words that I didn't get. At the Queens Museum in Flushing, Queens, and Making Sense, five artist installations on Sensation at the Katona Museum of Art in Katona, New York. She has lectured extensively on public art, contemporary art, and design across the country and abroad. Would you please welcome Stacy and Patti, please?
Images. I kind of want to look at them while we're talking, but I don't want to put our back
to
all of you.
Very blurred about that. Yeah.
But anyhow, it's great to be here with you and to be here with all of you this morning. Thank you all for coming. And it was interesting. About a month ago, you and I met at Bartram's Garden, and we sat in one of your glorious river rooms. and had a wonderful picnic lunch, which you brought, and thank you so much. And then about a week and a half later, I came back, but I came back with a group of one of our graduate students at Moore, as well as about 12 of our new incoming first-year students to talk with you about your work. That was amazing. And now here we have another more expanded forum to continue our kind of ongoing conversation that many started many, many years ago. And I don't know if this was definitely an early encounter with you and your work, and maybe we met earlier than this, but I remember being invited to go to the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign in 1997 to look at an exhibition and ultimately write one of the essays about this exhibition. And it was called Eco-Revelatory Design, Nature Constructed and Nature Revealed.